Live from Moscow, this is RT with me, Yulia Shapovalova, and we start off with breaking news for you this hour. Georgian police have clashed with opposition supporters in the capital, Tbilisi. This comes as the government has decided to disperse protests, which have been running for 5 days in a row now. And for more, we're now joined on the phone by our correspondent, Sarah Firth, who's in Tbilisi. Hello there, Sarah. So where are you and what's happening there at the moment? Any injured?
Well, we're just near the main parliament building where the protests were happening and where the violence broke out just a little while ago. Now, there's still a very, very heavy police presence around that area. There were a huge number that turned out to disperse the crowds. They came in from both sides. There were columns on both sides of those crowds that moved in just after midnight. Today, Georgia's Day of Independence, and it's starting with those violent clashes between the police and demonstrators. Now, what we saw after they cleared the main demonstration very, very quickly, they were firing water cannons, rubber bullets. There was a lot of gas around as well. It was extremely hectic, extremely violent. It happened very, very quickly. It really escalated very fast. You could see people being thrown to the ground. The protesters themselves, a lot of them had their faces covered and were carrying sticks. Just before the police, when they were walking up, the crowds were getting extremely het up. There was a lot of shouting, a lot of aggression going on. So as we said, when they actually entered the crowd, it happened extremely fast. So at the moment, the police are still on the scene, and the area around is devastated. The main trucks on which the opposition party were giving their talks today to the crowd, that's all been destroyed. The posters hanging off now. You can actually see the rubber bullets and the empty shells on the street. And the police are dispersing the people who are still there. Now, what we've actually seen, we've just been up near one of the buildings where the police are still emptying those buildings and making arrests for some of the people inside. We weren't actually too sure what was going on because these people, it's been pouring with rain today. A lot of these people we saw being pulled out of the buildings were blown dry, so they obviously hadn't been taking part in that main demonstration. But they were coming out of those buildings. There was glass everywhere, and they were bloody as well and being arrested and put into the van and driven away, and that's all still going on at the moment.
Yeah. Are there any reports of any arrests were made? And actually, we're getting reports right now, right here, that several journalists have been detained by the police there. What's going to happen to them now?
Well, we've heard the same reports. We haven't got any confirmation on the Georgian media being arrested, but we do know that a number of the correspondents and camera crews that were around on the scene have been quite severely injured. We've heard one colleague who'd had his fingers broken, another's got quite a serious head injury. Lots of cameras were destroyed when it all started. I mean, we were warned beforehand, and certainly that was the case, that when the violence started, the police weren't distinguishing at all between media and the demonstrators. And of course, as we said, it was all the more shocking because this has been dubbed the Silver Revolution. So a lot of the people in the crowd were of an older generation, and we could see a lot of those people coming out, and a lot of the people being arrested with serious injuries, heavy bleeding, and they were all quite old. So that was certainly very shocking. As we said, you have the media as well getting involved in that. Now, we know that neither of the Jeanne, what we've heard is that she's the leader of one of the main opposition parties and the opposition party that led the rally today. Apparently, she's not been arrested. She's been let go. But there's certainly been a large number of arrests made. Now, the number of police actually was speaking to the Georgian correspondents who were here, and they were there for the November 2007 protests as well. They said the number of police outnumbered even those protests. The numbers in comparison to how many protests there were, there really was no comparison. And 1,000 protesters at most remaining in that central square when the police entered. There were thousands of police. There were armoured vehicles, and the violence really escalating extremely quickly.
Right, Sarah. And can you briefly remind us about how these protests started?
Well, the protesters have been holding vigils for the last 5 days outside the public TV station in Georgia, in Tbilisi here. And they decided to move today, so we saw them marching this morning down the street. They blocked off the traffic. They're certainly causing a disturbance down to that main parliament building. Now, they weren't actually sanctioned to be there, so it was thought right from the beginning that perhaps there would be the police interference and they would try and disperse the crowds. And, of course, That's what we've seen happen. I don't think people were expecting quite the level of violence, and certainly not the numbers of police that showed up. And now in the last couple of days, what we actually saw, where the protest started over the weekend, there were those clashes between the demonstrators and police. We saw some injuries and we saw some arrests. But in the last couple of days, there's actually been divisions amongst the opposition themselves. Now, they'd initially come together, and what they called for was for Wednesday to be a day of fury. Now, that actually got called off at the last minute, as we said, because of divisions amongst the opposition. And it was thought that that had perhaps confused protesters, because in the last couple of days, the numbers that have been turning up to that area that they'd set up camp outside the TV station have been markedly less. Yesterday morning, the numbers weren't that large. Certainly nowhere near what we saw at the beginning of the protest, but later on in the day, as they started the march, the numbers gathering again, and when they reached the main area outside Parliament today, they were in their thousands again. But as we said, when the police showed up, they far outnumbered the protesters, and so it was very, very quick to disperse the crowds, but quite shocking to see.
All right, Sarah Firth reporting there live from Tbilisi. Sarah, thank you very much indeed for that report, and we'll talk to you later, of course. And RT correspondent Katerina Azarova previously witnessed a brutal crackdown on massive opposition protests back in 2007. Police then also used tear gas and water cannon to disperse thousands of demonstrators, injuring almost 600 people. And she's joining us live at the moment. Katya, thank you very much for joining us. So you were there when riot police used tear gas and violence during the massive crackdown in 2007. So describe what you remember, what happened there.
Oh, it all happened very suddenly, Yulia. I remember that we, along with many other journalists, were just outside the Parliament building on Tbilisi's Rustaveli Avenue. Hundreds of people were there protesting. There was the usual cordon of police, and all of a sudden the police started to leave. And I remember the people got very excited, and we asked them what had happened, and they said the police are on the people's side. They're leaving because they're letting us protest. And then we heard the policemen talking amongst themselves, and they said, we have to leave. The riot police is here, and they're wearing full gas masks. So even the police didn't know that tear gas would be used. And then the next thing we know, there were tear gas grenades flying everywhere. Immediately, we couldn't see anything, couldn't really breathe. It was chaos, people running in all kinds of directions. They were being met by riot police, literally started hammering down on them with their batons, just kicking people to the ground, beating them on their heads. There's mass chaos everywhere. Of course, people blinded. They couldn't really see anything because the tear gas was everywhere. There were dozens of ambulances immediately on the scene, just carrying people away. All of those that were injured, dozens ended up in hospitals. Loads of people, including the journalists, were injured. Ourselves amongst those we got in the first wave of the tear gas attack. And then later, our producer got hit in the head with a rubber bullet. Our camera crew also got struck by some of those rubber bullets. It was utter chaos and madness. But the most frightening thing about it, perhaps, was the fact that it was literally so unexpected. The protest had been going on for days, and nobody expected it to turn this violent this suddenly.
Yes, and back then, almost 600 people were treated in hospitals, and many of them women and children. So did the police act selectively or indiscriminately from your point of view?
From what we could see, they were literally just hitting everybody and anybody they could get their hands on. Basically, if you were in their way, they would kick you down to the ground. They started pushing people away. They tried to grab people, detain people. The only thing that we could do was shout press at them and try and wave some sort of press identification or cards or show cameras, microphones, anything to make them stop, to basically prevent them from hitting us. And it was really thanks to the local people that we avoided most of their brutality, because they literally started grabbing all the journalists that were working in Rustaveli Avenue that day and is dragging them off to their houses or the nearby shops and hotels, just treating people, giving us milk, giving us some solutions to wash our eyes with, just basically doing everything they could to help. But the police, from what we could see, were just literally layering into everybody and anybody who was in their way. It was very brutal and quite scary.
Right. The opposition fought for change in 2007 and is fighting now. Do you think this time they'll achieve anything?
Well, it's very difficult to guess, of course, with any sort of riots, whether they will actually achieve any sort of change in power or any effect that they are campaigning for. But from what we've seen recently within the government of Mikhail Saakashvili, it is very unlikely, I guess, that some sort of changes will presume, because Saakashvili has shown that he's not willing to take into account the demands of all of those protesting. This isn't, of course, the first time that he has called on the riot police or the military to bear down and protest, to disperse those protesters really violently. And that, of course, isn't a great negotiation tactic, but it doesn't also give the opposition forces much hope that their voices will actually be heard. I mean, the last time a protest like this went on, people got, 600 people ended up in hospitals. There was a military curfew established in Tbilisi. There were TV stations being pulled off the air in the middle of their broadcast. It was utter chaos, and of course showed to everybody that Saakashvili was prepared to use brutal force to show to his people that he's not prepared to listen to their voices. And perhaps, unless he's changed his position somehow, this is exactly what it's going to end up like again.
All right, Katerina Azara reporting there live for us. Katerina, thank you very much indeed.